Hi, my name is Andrei Osuchuk. I welcome you to another video training on Analysis Workspace in Adobe Analytics. Today I'm going to show you one of my favorite tricks that I call Invisible Panel in Analysis Workspace. What you can see on the screen is my project. As you see, it contains a number of different visualizations and all of them are inside one panel. Before I show you what the invisible panel is and how to leverage this panel, I want to explain you the scenario. The scenario is the following. As an analyst, I was asked to prepare some data analysis and to share the insights that I uncovered during the analysis with a team. And my team is not only my colleagues from digital department. This is also those who work on the marketing. This is also somebody from senior management. So different type of stakeholders. And I understand that if I want to share these insights, I don't need to include and I don't want to include all type of deep dive data analysis that I have conducted. Just because I understand that all these, let's say, tables with different breakdowns, lots of different metrics, is not what the insight is. I want to explain my insight, the outcome of the analysis, in a very simple way. And let's imagine that these four visualizations that you currently see on the screen are supplemented with some descriptions, comments, so that it's clear what the purpose of these visualizations is. It's clear what the insight is. And this is why I don't want to include these type of things that you can see on the bottom of the panel, because in these visualizations I have so much details that I don't want to share. Maybe I also have some additional panels, and those panels also may contain lots of different data insights, but it's not clear how to read them. But I want to make sure that everybody who will receive this project will be able to read it. I also know that somebody, like for example, those who are from senior management, may want to ask somebody to print this project so that they can probably better look at it, because they are not familiar with Adobe Analytics. They even may not want to log into Adobe Analytics, and probably sometimes the PDF is not the best way when you are on the meeting and you want to discuss something. Who knows? I don't know. But my point is, you want to show some insights, but at the same time, you do not want to show your deep dive data analysis or visualizations. What options you have? One of the options is to collapse those panels and visualizations to make sure that everybody who will read your project will be focused on those visualizations that are expanded. Another way that you may think about is you may want to create a copy of this project, delete everything that you don't want to include, and then share it. But the disadvantage of this method would be that if next day you will prepare something else, you will continue working on your data analysis, those updates will not be synchronized automatically with the copy of the project, and you will need to do this manually every time when you want to share some updates. You either will need to copy your updates to your second project, or you will need to share every single time a new copy that you have created. So what I'm going to show you today is to how to make sure that all the data that you don't want to show will be invisible for those who will work with this project. Basically, I will show you how to hide them completely, and this is what I call invisible panel. You look at this project and you see obviously one panel, but what if I tell you that there are more than one panels? I think you will not believe me, because you can't see anything, right? So let me again show you that this is just one panel. But I bet that there are more panels that you can see. And this is what I call invisible panels. So let me show you what invisible panels are. Have a look at what I'm doing. I actually open a new panel that you didn't expect. And let's imagine that this is one of the deep dive analysis that I don't want to show to those I will be sharing this project with. And this is why I made it invisible. I also can open another panel that I also have in my project. So now you see that I have even more panels, and this panel also contains some valuable data for me as an analyst, because I can continue tomorrow to do further analysis for my own purpose to properly show the insights for those I will be sharing this with, which is this panel, the panel acquisition in my case. So now you may already guess, or maybe not, how to make the panel invisible. The trick is the following. You just need to resize the panel so that it will be so small and it will become invisible. Look at this. I make the panel very small and it has disappeared. Let me show you again how this works. I just start resizing the panel. The panel becomes smaller. I continue resizing the panel. It may take a few attempts to make it completely invisible, but it's absolutely workable solution. So let's make it completely invisible. And this one as well. Now we do not see any other panels. Only one panel is in the project. The beauty of this solution is that you can export this in PDF format and those invisible panels will not be shown. And this is how it works. I hope you really like this tip. If you want to say thank you for this video training, the best way to do that is to hit on the like icon under this video and share this video with your friends. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for new tips and new trainings on Analysis Workspace. Thank you for watching. Talk to you next time. Bye.